Hello mates, what is up? In this episode of PerspicaceCafe, do you know that the biggest ship can accommodate a maximum 6,680 passengers? How big was Titanic as compared to today's ships? Do you know that the companies operating cruise ships are actually in two businesses, not one? Stay tuned to find out. Cruising has become a major part of the tourism industry, with an estimated market of over $45 billion per year and over 26 million passengers carried worldwide annually. Cruise ships are large passenger ships used mainly for vacationing. They can carry thousands of passengers in a single trip and are some of the largest ships in the world, even bigger than many cargo ships. Operators of cruise ships are known as cruise lines. Just like operators of airplanes are called airlines, cruise lines are companies that sell cruises to the public. They have a dual character. Not like humans, yeah, not like human beings, but it's the nature of the business they are in. They are partly in the transportation business and partly in the leisure entertainment business, a duality that carries down into the ships themselves, which have both a crew headed by the ship's captain and a hospitality staff headed by the equivalent of a hotel manager. The passenger's ticket include a cabin or a compartment with sleeping accommodation, room service, unlimited meals in the main dining room, access to shows, and use of pulsome gym facilities, while there is a daily gratuity or small charge to cover the housekeeping and waiter service. However, there are extra charges for alcohol and soft drinks, official cruise photos, internet, etc. Cruise ships are similar and organized much like floating hotels. It's not uncommon for the most luxurious ships to have more crew and staff than passengers. Historically, the cruise ship business has been volatile. These ships are large capital intensive with high operating costs. A persistent decrease in booking can put a company into a financial mess. If the maintenance is unscheduled, it can result potentially in thousands of dissatisfied customers. Cruise lines have sold, renovated, and renamed their ships to keep up with the travel trends. Cruising has faced a dramatic change over the course of a few decades, with the changes in lifestyle, communication, and what people do for entertainment. Cruise lines understands and change with that. They operate their ships almost constantly. It's a fun fact that people go on vacation in these humongous giants, but these ships are never on vacations. Modern cruise ships are typically have upwards some of the following facilities like casino, spa, library, parlor, cinema, fitness center, gaming center, and even swimming pool with water slides and whatnot. There have been 9 or more new cruise ships added every year since 2001. In bit more than 3 decades between 1988 to 2020, the largest cruise ships grew enormously longer from 268 meters to 362 meters in length, from 32 meters to 66 meters in breadth, and total passengers capacity from 2,700 to about astonishing 5,500. Cruising has certainly changed dramatically over the years. Ships are ranked by gross tonnage. For special viewers who are new to this term, gross tonnage is the volume of space within the hull and enclosed spaces above the deck of the ship which are available for cargo, stores, fuel, passengers, and crew. Along with gross tonnage, the date they entered service is also taken into account. The Noah's Ark was the ship in the year estimated between 2500 BC to 2300 BC. With only 8 peoples, but 2 of each and every kind of land-based animals were accommodated in Noah's Ark. The fact is that all the animals only required less than 30% of the space on the ark, meaning there was a lot of breathing and wiggle room for everyone. From the Mayflower in the year 1609 to the Great Titanic in the year 1911, from the Sovereign of the Seas in the year 1988 to the Norwegian Epic in 2009, cruising has evolved dramatically over the course of history. As of 2020, the world's largest passenger ship is Royal Caribbean Symphony of the Sea. She is 361 meters in length and has a gross tonnage of 2,28,081 across 18 decks. She is able to accommodate about 5,518 passengers at double occupancy rate up to maximum capacity of 6,680 passengers, as well as capacity of 2,200 crew members. She can achieve a speed of 22 knots or 41 km per hour. For size perspective, Symphony of the Seas is about 30 meters longer than the largest military ship ever built, the US Nimitz class aircraft carrier. When compared to landmarks, Symphony of the Seas is as long as 3 full and 1/2 football fields and twice as long as the height of Washington Monument. Okay, let me show you something. This is the Titanic. And this is the Symphony of the Seas. I don't think there is anything much to say about this. Modern cruise ships are tall but remain stable due to their relatively low center of mass. This is due to the large open spaces and extensive use of aluminium, high-strength steel and other lightweight materials in the upper part, and the fact that the heaviest components, the engine, propellers, fuel tank and other such components are located at the bottom of the hull. Even though modern cruise ships may appear tall with proper weight distribution, but when it comes to energy, cruise ships require electrical power, normally provided by diesel generators, although an increased number of new ships are fueled by liquefied natural gas. When docked, ships must run their generators continuously to power the onboard facilities unless they are capable of using onshore power where available. Polluting emissions from diesel engines can be equivalent to 700 trucks running their engines. And that is very harmful when ships dock in areas which are itself polluted enough. Some cruise ships already support the use of shore power, while others are being adapted to do so. As most of the passengers on cruise are affluent and have considerable ransom of potential, not to mention the considerable amount of cash and jewelry on board. For example, in casinos and shops, there have been several high-profile pirate attacks on cruise ships. As a result, cruise ships are implemented various security measures, while most merchant shipping firms have generally avoided arming crews and security guards for reason of safety, liability, and conformity with the laws of the countries where they are docked. Cruise ships have small arms, usually semi-automatic pistols, stored in a safe, accessible only by the captain, who distributes them to the authorized personnel such as security or the master at arms. Now, if you made it to the end, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon, because as you might have heard, it really helps the channel. So I really appreciate if you guys subscribe so that you never miss anything in future. At last, thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time.